H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.
Welcome to H2K Infosys. This is a demo session on the Selenium testing tool. And this will be the agenda for today. I will introduce you to our organization H2K Infosys, and then we'll have a look at some basics of software engineering concepts and the testing. Then we'll have a look at the Selenium syllabus, the competitive edge that is provided by H2K Infosys, and then we'll have a look at schedule. Let me introduce myself. My name is Priya. I'm a senior automation tester with more than 10 years of experience in this IT field, and with H2K Infosys I work as a faculty to provide the QA, the automation and certification based courses. Now let me introduce you to our organization. We are from H2K Infosys and we are E-Verified Business based in Atlanta. We provide the software training and job placement assistance, and this is our client network. We work with GE, AT&T, Intercall, Dish Network, Wells Fargo, Verizon, Sony, Bank of America, Blue Cross Blue Shield and many others who are located across US. And these are the world-class services that are provided by H2K Infosys. We provide the IT trainings and the project work for the corporates, individuals and MS students. We do the software design, development, testing and maintenance. We provide the IT staff augmentation, the job placement assistance and the technical support. And these are the various courses that are offered by H2K Infosys. We provide all the different types of testing courses like manual, automation, performance testing, SAP testing, the mainframe, JUnit testing, ETL testing, Unix and Linux, web services based testing, mobile application testing. We also have the advanced courses in the automation testing tools like HP QTP, the performance testing tool HP LoadRunner. We provide the BA and project management training along with the Agile Scrum. The developer courses, Data Warehouse, SAP Modules, DBA, Selenium and many others. So we are basically into the IT trainings and placements. We are specialists in providing the IT trainings and placements. So this is an introduction to our organization. Now most of the participants who enroll in this QA course are from non-IT background, and that is why we'll discuss little bit of basics before we start with the testing concepts. First of all, we have the definition of the software. Software is a set of programs that is developed for specific purpose. And we have several examples of the software here, like the Gmail, Microsoft Office tools, internet banking application, the online shopping sites, the billing systems in Walmart and Macy's. There are plenty of mobile applications that are available, the operating system, the browsers, calculator program. So you can find plenty of examples of the software if you just check around you in your day-to-day activities. And software is applicable to the various fields. It could be the banking and financial services, customer relationship management, the retail business, telecom business, manufacturing companies. So you name any kind of companies, you find the application of the software. And due to this kind of wide variety of application of the software, there are a lot of IT projects that are currently in line. And the main reason why people go for the IT field, because there are a lot of job opportunities available. Secondly, you get a good pay scale. The third and most important thing is, even though you're from non-IT background or you have any kind of gap in the career, still you can make your career in this IT field. So this is about the software and its application. Now, to develop the software, we follow certain well-defined steps. We start with the requirement gathering, wherein the business analyst meets the client on behalf of our entire IT project team to gather the project information. It could be the different features or the functionalities that are to be implemented in the software, how many users would be using the software, what should be the performance of the software, the security features that are to be implemented. So basically, the BA gathers all the project information. Based on these requirements, the planning is done by the project manager and the detailed analysis of these requirements is done by the business analyst. Then the software is designed, which is completely a technical activity. And in the design phase, the programming logic is created by an architect. Based on the design, the developers are developing the software. The developers write the programs or they do the coding here. Then the testing is done by the QA. And the software is released to the client, which is a combined effort. So this forms our IT project team. Now, though these are IT professionals, they commit certain errors or the mistakes. No matter how qualified or experienced people are, the human errors or the mistakes cannot be avoided. And due to this kind of human mistakes or the errors, for example, a BA is meeting the client, missing some information to be gathered. A developer might do some kind of errors in the programs. Due to an architect, there could be some kind of flaw in the design. So due to this kind of human mistakes or the errors, the defects are getting introduced into the software. And when we release a defective software to the client, it results into the failure. So what is the solution now? Solution is testing. You have to test the software and make sure that a defect-free software is released to the client, and that is how the failure can be avoided. So what exactly is testing? Testing is all about identifying the defects in the software, and also we got to verify the requirements of the client. This is how the testing is defined. Now, in order to do the testing, there are different steps that are to be followed. So in the testing participants, first of all, there is test requirement gathering. Which is done by the QA. The QA gathers the requirements from the business analyst. And then there is a test planning and analysis. Test planning is done by the test lead. The test design. The different test documents like the test cases are created here. Test implementation and execution, wherein the test environment is set up and the software is tested. Then we have the defect reporting and tracking. And finally, we stop the testing, that is test closure. So these are the different steps that are to be followed in the software testing. Now, participants, There are two ways in order to do the testing. The testing can either be done manually, wherein the human testers will execute the steps. They will enter the test data and check if the software is behaving as per the expectations of the client. And the testing can also be done automatically using the software, wherein we use the testing tools in order to do the testing. Now look at these different steps of testing. When we talk about the automation testing, it's practically not possible that all the steps could be automated. For example, we have the requirement gathering. There cannot be an automation testing tool which can automatically go and gather the requirements from the BA. There cannot be an automation testing tool which will automatically write the test cases for you, right? There cannot be an automation testing tool which will automatically create the plan for you. Then when we talk about the automation testing, what exactly is getting automated here? So here in this entire process, it is the test execution that is getting automated here. So when we say we are doing the automation testing, it's not that we are able to automate each and every step of the software testing, but it's only the execution that is getting automated here, wherein the automation testing tool will automatically check by executing the steps and then verifying the behavior of the software. So here is a definition of the automation testing. Test automation means it is a use of the software, that is automation testing tool, in order to control the execution of the test and also compare the actual results with the expected result. Now the question is, why should we go for an automation? What's the purpose? The automation testing is much more faster when compared to the manual testing. You can execute many tests, or you can say you can test many functionalities or the features of the software in short duration of time. It is more reliable because as a human tester, you might make the errors. You might make the errors because of the complexity of the project, due to the lethargy, because the human testers might get tired, and then there is a lot of testing that has to be done, huge amount of testing. Many test cases have to be executed. So due to this kind of various reasons, there are possibilities that the human might commit the error. But the automation testing tool, once configured properly, it's not committing any kind of error. That's why we say that automation testing tools are more reliable when compared to the human testers. Whenever we have the repeatable steps means, for example, let's consider the login functionality. So how do we test the login functionality, participants? We have to follow certain steps. First of all, we enter the username and then we enter the password. Then we click on the sign in button. So these are the three steps that we have to execute in order to test the login functionality. Now at each of these steps, we can enter the different combinations of the data. For example, we enter the valid username, valid password, invalid username, invalid password, valid username, invalid password, invalid username, valid password, both of them blank, valid username, blank password, and then so on. So we can test with the different combinations of the data. So do you see? The same steps of testing are getting repeated for the different combinations of the data. And whenever we have to do this kind of repeatable testing, we can go for the automation instead of doing it manually. Then it is programmable. means the condition-based testing. Let me show you an example. In the net banking application, we have a functionality called as fund transfer. So when the user is selecting the fund transfer option, the fund transfer page opens, wherein there are different methods of fund transfer, like same bank transfer, the different bank transfers, international transfers. So there are different methods of fund transfer. If the user has selected the same bank transfer, the different steps have to be followed. If the user has selected the different bank transfer, there are different set of steps that are to be followed. So do you see, based on the option that is selected here, there are different steps that are to be followed. So here in this kind of testing participants, which has to be done automatically, based on the option that is selected, some set of steps have to be executed, wherein some kind of conditional program is required. And that is why we can go for the automation testing, which is also programmable here. Then comprehensive means detailed testing is possible using this automation. And then automation testing is reusable. Now let's consider the same fund transfer functionality. It will be tested several times before we release a software to the client, because we have to conduct the different types of testing. For example, we have to conduct the functional testing. The initial level testing has to be done. Retesting has to be done in case if there are any defects. If there are new features that are getting added into the software or some kind of changes that are happening in the software, we have to test these changes by doing the regression testing. So do you see, participants, there are different types of testing that have to be done on the same functionality. And that is why using this automation testing tool, we can create the script which can be reused any number of times for the different types of testing. So you create the script once and you can reuse it any number of times. So these are some of the benefits of the automation testing. Now, in order to conduct the automation testing, there are so many different automation testing tools that are available. Selenium is getting very popular these days. We also have the QTP or the UFT tool from the HP company. The Rational tools from the IBM. The other tools are like Test Complete, Robotium, the Silk Test. So there are plenty of automation testing tools that are available. Now the question is, how do you select the tool for your project then? So while you select the tool, participants, there are certain criteria that you have to consider, and we call it as a tool selection criteria. First of all, it should meet the requirement. It should match the technology of the software that we are currently testing. It should be user friendly, because the software testers are usually from the non-programming background, and whatever tool we are going to implement in the project, they should have a good understanding about it if we have to make use of maximum number of features of the tool. So it should be a user-friendly tool, and it should be compatible with the test environment, means the system on which we are doing the testing, and also the other testing tools that will be installed in this test environment. So it should be compatible with both the test environment and also the other testing tools which are installed in this test environment. The price should be within the budget of our project. We have to select the tool from a vendor carefully, because there are possibilities that we might not get a proper technical support from the vendor sometimes. Sometimes they might go out of business. Sometimes the vendor might make the tool as a licensed version. So you have to check the various scenarios before you select the tool. So these are the common criteria that we consider before we make the selection of the automation testing tool. So in this course, we will have a look at a very important and popular tool these days, which is called as Selenium. So Selenium is a very popular automation testing tool. It is an open source. Open source in the sense, it's a free tool. That is the first thing. Second thing is, participants, you can add more number of commands into the existing system. And it's a cross-platform tool. Means you can test the different operating system plus the browsers over here. The different operating system and the browser combination you can test. That's why we call it as the cross-platform tool. It also supports the various different languages like Java, Ruby, C Sharp, Python, Perl and so on. And it is supporting only the web-based application testing. So you can test all the web-based applications using the Selenium tool. Now, participants, before you select the tool for your learning purpose, you have to find out what is the scope in the market. So here I take you to the Indeed.com. It's a very popular job website, you must be knowing. Like we have the CareerBuilder.com, then the Dice.com, Monster.com. So we have this similar kind of job websites which is very popular in US and we call it as Indeed.com. And here they have some option to find out the job trend. For example, do you see participants here? I can give the names of the different job roles, testing tools, different technologies, and then I can make the comparison among the different options that are available. For example, let me compare the Selenium tool. So here I can type Selenium. Then I can make the comparison with, let's say, the UFT tool. And then click on the Find Trends button. So it will compare and give you the result here. So do you see here, participants? We have the Selenium here, the blue line. This is representing the Selenium. And then this orange color line, this is representing the UFT. And you can see here, the Selenium is rising as of now in the market. It has more number of job opportunities when compared to the UFT tool. So here you have the job seeker interest. So people are going more towards this Selenium tool. You can see the trend here. All right. You can see the trend here. March 11th, March 20, up to March 22, you have the trend available here. Okay. So if you compare, you find that Selenium is as of now leading in the market. You can also compare the other tools also. For example, the Rational tool. You can call it as RFT. Or I'll type it as Rational tool from the IBM company. So do you see, you have the trend available for the Rational tool also. Okay. So they are giving you the statistics, and anyways, you are able to find that Selenium is as of now leading in the market. So now, participants, let's have a look at the syllabus that is offered by H2K Infosys. So we are conducting the 30 hours course here for the Selenium tool, wherein we start right from the testing basics, because we have designed this course for the people who are even from the non-IT background. So if you want to start your career in this IT field as a QA, and Selenium you want to choose as the testing tool for your skill, so this is the course that is suitable for you. So we start right from the testing basics, and then we'll have a look at the Selenium tool, the introduction part. What exactly is Selenium? Why the Selenium is being used? What are the different features and components of the Selenium? how to get the Selenium installed, because this is a free tool, it's an open source, so you should be able to install it very easily on your computer. And there is a very important component here called as Selenium IDE. The programming language that is used, it's the core Java, the Java programming language. Actually, the Java has two parts over here. The core Java means the basic Java, and then the advanced Java is there. So core Java and advanced Java, both of them are required in case if you're doing the Java development. But if you're learning the Selenium tool, this advanced Java is not required. Only the basic part of the Java, that is core Java, is required. So we will be spending about 10 hours over here in order to learn this Java programming language so that you can use it for the Selenium tool. Then we have the another important component here that is called as Selenium WebDriver, wherein we are going to use this Java programming language, and then we will see how the testing can be done. Then we have the different frameworks of the testing. The third party tools are used. So these are the different topics that will be covered. Apart from this, as I mentioned, we will be focusing on the core Java concepts. We will consider the real-time projects and examples over here. And also the domain-based learning will be done. Apart from this, participants, in order to help you with the job placement, we will provide you with the resume preparation classes. Unlimited hours of mock interview sessions would be conducted. Then we will have the domain-based learning. Now, if you consider any kind of tool or technology, it is essential that you should have the hands-on practice. If I just show you here on my screen how the tool works, how the testing is done, and then later you go to your job place, you will not be able to work on that. As of now, you might understand everything, but then when you start working on it, you may not be able to have the hands-on on it. So that is why right here in the class, we are going to provide you the hands-on practice on the documentation work, the test documents, plus the testing tool practice. So we'll install the testing tool on your computer, that is Selenium tool on your computer, and then we will provide you with the hands-on practice here. So participants, you can compare our syllabus with any other training center in entire US, and you'll find that H2K Infosys has the highest number of topics that will be covered at a very competitive price. So this is our Selenium testing course syllabus. Now there are different services that are offered by H2K Infosys. So you see that we have a very huge course syllabus, and we have all the US-based trainers here who will provide you with the training. This is pay only one time, and you can retake the sessions any number of times. Because participants, we understand that since you are using this testing tool for the first time, and then you cannot completely understand the entire 60 minutes of the session, maybe you are unable to pay attention, or maybe you miss something in between. So those things are quite common, and that is why in order to help you revise and then cope up with such things, we are going to provide you with the videos. You can go through the videos and then you can revise the topics for the day. Then we help you with the resume preparation and mock interview session. The testing tool will be installed on your computer for your hands-on practice. We have the technical support team available if you need an assistance. Anyways, for Selenium, we don't need that much of technical support because we will be installing it right away in the class. Then we have the domain-based learning. We give you a lot of assignments and also review the work. And our training is based on the latest technologies and current job market. So we continuously keep a watch on what is happening in the job market based on the requirements of the client, based on the requirements of the employers, and then the job descriptions, we are making the changes in the syllabus. So we regularly keep our syllabus updated. And then we have the forums, blogs, videos, and also the job portal available from H2K Infosys for your placement activities. Now participants, let me take you to our website wherein you can find all the detailed information. It is www.h2kinfosys.com. And if you visit our website, participants, you can find all the information over here. So we have the list of courses here: Quality Assurance, Business Analysis, ISTQB, Advanced QTP and UFT, and then we have the Selenium syllabus over here. So select the Selenium option and then scroll down. You can find the complete syllabus over here. So you have the course highlights plus the syllabus. So we start right from the basics. We will learn what is the meaning of automation testing, how the automation has to be done, why it has to be done. Then we'll have a look at the Selenium IDE. Then we have these Selenium locators, means how the Selenium tool is going to work, the Firebug tool, how it will work, the XPath, the different objects of the application. Then what are the main features of the Selenium, Selenium IDE concepts, and then some of the Selenium commands which are called as Selenese commands we will have a look at. How to use a Selenium IDE in order to do the testing. Then we have the Selenium WebDriver, wherein we are going to use mainly the Java concepts, and that is why we'll spend some time learning the Java language as well. This is a programming language. Then we'll have a look at the parameterization. Then the framework based testing will be done. There are some advanced concepts that we have included over here, like the framework based testing and then how to use the third party tools. This is the complete syllabus of our Selenium course. And there are some more services that are provided by H2K. So we have the job portal from where you can apply for the jobs. Forums in order to interact with the other candidates of H2K Infosys. Now, why the interaction is required, participants? See, I think all of you have your Facebook account. It's a social networking site. What is the purpose that you use it? It's not just used for the communication purpose, but then you can get all the updates, like what is happening around the world. You get the information, and then you can also use it in order to resolve so many of your issues. Similarly, if you are building your IT professional network, it will be useful in so many different ways. You can get in touch with the other IT professionals, and then you can find out what are the updates that are happening in the technology. How do you know there is a new testing tool in the market? So you can discuss it over the forum, and then you can find this kind of information in the forum. Let's say you have some technical issue during your job in the workplace. So you can share your technical issue here, and then there will be many people who will be assisting you with the solutions. So in various different ways you can use the forums. Then we are going to conduct the project-based session. So we are going to show you, participants, using the Selenium tool, how to automate a real-time project. So we will consider a real-time project example and show you how the automation testing can be done using the Selenium. We will give you the detailed course materials plus the pre-recorded videos for your learning purpose. And you can find our reviews on Google Plus, Kudzu, Facebook and YouTube. For the job placement assistance, we have an exclusive team. I will show you some of the reviews, participants. So this is an independent site that you can see here, wherein you can find the reviews of the different trainers of H2K Infosys. So these are some of the reviews. It is kudzu.com. So if you visit this kudzu.com, you can find some of the reviews of our candidates over here. There are many pages, in fact. So you can visit this site and then you can check on your own. So participants, do you see? We have the excellent training faculty here in H2K Infosys. Basically, when we hire the trainers, it's not that we just consider their experience and teaching skills, but apart from that, participants, we also make sure that they are certified trainers. so that you get the knowledge which is acceptable in the different IT companies. So we have the very expert faculty here who are experienced and also who are certified. Then we also have the Google Plus here, and here also you can find the reviews that are posted on our faculty. And again, not just the faculty participants, even we have the technical support team. So do you see, we have this person Kiran, who is a technical support team person, and we get even the excellent support from our team in order to do the installations. You can even check on the Google Plus as well. You can find us even on the Facebook and YouTube. There also we have uploaded lot of videos. We in fact have our own YouTube channel wherein we have uploaded the YouTube videos of the different technologies. You can have a look there. The live sessions you can view there. Now regarding the Selenium schedule participants, the duration is going to be about 30 hours for the completion of the course. We have both the weekday and weekend batches. For more details regarding the batches, you can check with our H2K Infosys training coordinators. And for the enrollment and the start date of the course, you can check with our training coordinators by calling this number 770-777-1269. And we also have our email IDs training@h2kinfosys.com or h2kinfosys@gmail.com. So these are our contact details. Now participants, who can take up this training? Anybody who is interested to make their career in this IT field as a QA and you want to choose Selenium as a expertise, so you can enroll in this Selenium testing course. So thank you everyone for attending the demo session for the Selenium tool. My name is Priya and I am the senior faculty here, and these are our contact details for your enrollment. Thanks once more participants for attending the demo session.